Should you use credit cards for their generous cashback and rewards, or does the psychology of borrowing and paying back later put you at risk for spending more or losing money? In this video, we're gonna go into the possible benefits and consequences to finally settle the great credit card debate, and make sure to watch until the end because the results may surprise you. Let's get started. What's going on, y'all? Mitchell Torrence here with Manifest Money Media, helping you make the most of your money. And on this channel, we talk about a lot of financial tools, resources, and strategies to help you create more income, consume less, learn to invest, and give the rest. So if you're new here and you want to up your financial game, consider subscribing and let's jump into the video. All right, so let's first look at an example of the benefits of someone using a credit card for their everyday purchases versus not. Charlie Cash and Frankie Finance both make $50,000 per year. Charlie and Frankie are both good savers and are able to invest 20% of their income into retirement, or $10,000 per year, which means that they spend $40,000 on all of their living expenses and discretionary spending. Now, Charlie Cash pays for all of his expenses on a debit card or using cash, so he doesn't make any money from credit card rewards or cash back. But Frankie Finance, on the other hand, purchases all of his living expenses using a simple 2% cashback credit card, using services like Plastic to pay for his mortgage or rent. He uses all the extra cashback and bonuses he makes to invest extra into his retirement accounts. 2% of $40,000 is $800, which means that Frankie Finance is investing $800 per year more than Charlie Cash. If they both invest from age 30 to 65 and get an average 10% return on their money, Charlie Cash will have roughly $3.1 million at retirement, while Frankie Finance will have $3.4 million, almost $300,000 or 10% more than Charlie Cash. While both of them will enjoy a solid retirement with a great income, it sounds like Frankie Finance made the better choice to use his credit cards, right? Well, not necessarily. There's some conflicting psychology behind using different payment methodologies to make a purchase. Here's where Frankie Finance could get into some trouble. In numerous studies done by Carnegie Mellon and the Journal of Consumer Research, MRI scans found that the pain centers of the brain are activated more when consumers pay with cash than with credit cards or digital payments. This is because when you hand someone a $100 bill, you physically see the store of value leaving your possession and over to someone else. Even when you pay with a debit card, your brain might think to itself, "Do I have enough money in my checking account to pay for this?" which is associated with less friction than paying with cash. More so, when a consumer uses a credit card, there's no material property leaving their possession, but their brain understands that even if they don't have the money to pay for something now, they can always pay it back later. Even further still, when you use a digital payment method linked to a credit card, like PayPal or Amazon, there's no swiping, no putting in numbers, just a simple click, and you've bought something, which is the least amount of traction between you and spending your money. Now, since money doesn't have any intrinsic value until it is used, I would assume that if I were to pay by bartering something like this $100 fossil watch, this would be the most painful way of spending. So basically, if you want to spend as little money as possible, just put all of your money into toilet paper and use that as your exchange of value. Just kidding. Don't put all your money into toilet paper. It was a joke, y'all. So obviously, credit card companies and businesses that offer their own cards want to make it as easy and pain-free as possible for you to buy something. But there are even more hidden reverse psychology tactics that these companies use. Oftentimes, they'll offer you tempting cashback and point systems to make you feel like you're being rewarded for spending more money. I've heard it like a million times from people:
"I just paid for my entire trip using my airline miles." Or, "I just used my cash back to pay for this expensive restaurant."
But at what cost? How much unnecessary shit did you have to buy to rack up those rewards? Not to mention, if you slip up on even one payment of your credit card cycle, the interest rates are insane. You could end up paying 18 to 24% interest on a simple purchase like groceries or gas.
No one should be paying a bank 18% interest on Tic Tacs. Get some f***ing cash together.
Left unchecked, you could also end up having to deal with debt collectors, legally having your wages garnished, and not to mention the stress that comes from not knowing if you'll be able to make your payments. By the way, a credit score is not all it's hyped up to be. All it means is that you're good at borrowing money. It doesn't mean that you have money or make good money, so please stop bragging about your credit score. Sorry guys, rant over. So back to our example, if Frankie Finance isn't being responsible with his spending or makes an out of control decision to spend over budget, he effectively has a net loss by using his credit cards because he spends more than he needs or pays unnecessary fees. But here's where the logic of people like Dave Ramsey may be flawed. If you're using his financial principles of following a strict budget, telling your money where to go before the month begins, and once the money runs out, you don't spend anymore, you theoretically shouldn't have any of the downsides of using a credit card, which I think is what it really boils down to. Do you trust yourself enough and have the self-control to only buy what you were going to buy if you were using cash? Do you have the discipline to pay your cards off in full each month and resist the temptation to pay things back later? Well, I sure do. My finances are almost entirely automated, and I've never gone over budget in a single month in the 4 years I've been keeping track. My spending is almost the exact same each month, and I've never bought more expensive organic avocados instead of GMO avocados solely because I'm using a credit card. Not to mention, the last 3 vacations I've taken, I've paid for all of the airfare just using my multiplier bonuses to stack rewards. I also made over $2,500 in 2019 between liquid cash and reward points from credit card churning, new bank account bonuses, and pairing the right credit cards with my purchases. Right now, I've got 4% cash back at restaurants, 4% on gas, 3% on groceries, and 2% on everything else. I've never missed a single monthly payment. I pay my balances in full each month, and I've never paid a single cent in interest. So what do I recommend you do? Well, the answer may be different for everyone. If you have the self-control to stick with your budget and not overspend, I'd recommend you leverage credit cards as a side hustle for their free rewards and cash back. I look at rewards as basically getting a discount on everything you buy, so why would you not utilize these benefits? But if you're the type of person that has a hard time sticking to your budget, buys random crap impulsively, or you know that you'll have a hard time paying the balance each month, don't use them. You could get yourself into some serious trouble if you're not careful, and the benefits do not outweigh the harm. There's a reason that the credit card is one of the most highly marketed financial products of all time, with the average household keeping over $8,000 in credit card debt, and credit card companies making ungodly amounts of money off of people being irresponsible or just plain stupid. And let's be honest, saving 2 or 3% is not going to be the catalyst that brings you to financial prosperity. Good financial habits and investing properly are going to help you out so much more. So evaluate your financial habits and figure out if credit cards are right for you. And if you do have credit card debt, I'll link a video above that shows you step by step how to get out of debt and build a more prosperous financial life. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next video.